That's neat. Okay. So this is the point where we start preparing for our operation against Odessa.
Angetreten.
And Kiev, since that is the main target, probably down to Mykolaiv even. These names are far too familiar at the moment, aren't they? Okay, so we're gonna kick it off from Rovna. What's Zhytomyr and then Kiev, if I'm not mistaken, those are the supply depots. Yeah, there's Zhytomyr and this one for the supply in front of Kiev. So that is a major target. Also allows us to outflank these positions. And the other offensive will be a bit more difficult. We could launch from here to Vincea and then cut down, but that is risky because that might allow them to save Odessa. So I think I'm gonna risk it and try an attack across the river here. Probably the best position for that to quickly advance would be to strike directly at Balta via this tile. Level 2 fortifications on the river though, so it won't be that easy. We have to try it nonetheless. So that's that target. And that's that target. We're gonna use the planning bonus initially for this. Yeah. Armies should disperse now. Gonna bring you guys there and you there. Just realized that that is actually 3 tiles from which we can attack that. Okay. Now give the army some time to reorganize and get ready. A bit far behind the line, so we're gonna deactivate that as we do here and there. That one is okay and still needed. That one isn't. Okay. So, I completely missed that, but the civil war in Vichy Syria caused Lebanon to join the Allies, and somehow they got troops, and yeah. So Syria is now free and in the Allies, so I have to divert these 10 divisions up here. And fix that situation. Okay. Yeah, I launched a little offensive here with the infantry to secure better positions. Yeah, we requested some garrison support, so that's some additional manpower for us. I really want more trucks. That's basically all I want. I want the truck event to fire so I can get trucks. By the way, how many trucks did we lose to attrition? 506 in the last 30 days. That's actually acceptable. And only one train, so we're fine in that regard. The Italians are already counter-naval invading, apparently. Probably immediately capitulating Lebanon there. Enemy air superiority, but yeah, it's nothing. Doesn't really matter. Okay, supply situation could be better, but it's also not too bad. Soviets are trying to counterattack in some regions, but it's not. Yeah. It's all right. Okay, these guys can go to Lvov and fly there now. I'm throwing some planes in the air here. That's dive bombers with their short range. Not exactly sure we could deploy them efficiently. Probably here. And then we have medium bombers that I'm gonna redeploy down south. That's light bombers, that's medium bombers. Okay. New agent. No Soviet agent, sadly. Oh, Soviet counterattack. Okay, since that position is currently relatively weak. Holding their ground nonetheless. Attacking across the river is just not a good idea. Yeah, these guys are waiting for supply and so on. Reinforcements, once that arrives, we should be golden. Just tell me I have enough trucks for that. Okay, we have enough trucks, good. It should improve the supply situation there sufficiently. What is the truck situation now? The 3.3, wait until the next day so we see. Hey, Vorondiel! Bit late in the year, but we already caused a lot of casualties on the Soviets. Next day says it's fine to upgrade that, so we're gonna do that. I need so many more trucks. Trucks, planes, everything is needed. Converting the older ones to something more modern. I'm gonna start converting these two. How are you? Yeah, these are currently being produced with 10. We have a lot of Geschützwagen 2 now, so soon we're gonna start branching out with them into the mechanized forces. The enemy is throwing his planes up. Okay, supply situation here is fixed. The minor supply bombing happening here. For that we have the fighters back on these airfields, but we have an airfield here now. Okay. Happening here, that's strategic bombing, okay. So the Air Force is already fighting back efficiently, that is not good. The fire control system. Okay. Why is that front so long? They're supposed to attack from only two tiles. Ah, okay, there goes Lebanon. Good. Yeah, that didn't happen. Good. Okay, they're quickly advancing. We're taking that. Good. Front line here is fine. How's the Bismarck doing? ...96%, almost time to pull it back home. Okay, we have to strike before the weather gets too bad. Oh, they still don't have the fuel. Fuck's sake. Italians are overstacking there. It's eating up my food and supplies. They're actually dropping because they're moving again. I hate that when they do this. I'm running out of time. Oh, the Americans just went for lend lease and so on. Oh, the missing tokens. Let's fix that. There we go. The Nazi masters of Germany made it clear that they intend. Come on, reinforcing. What are we short on? I should have all equipment that is needed for the tanks. Yeah, our equipment situation is actually solid. Soon it's time to start the first divisions with Stuck support. I'm going to dedicate those completely to the infantry this time around. A ton of medium tanks. But we're starting to build ever more heavy mediums. I actually tuned down the medium production already because we're going to concentrate on these. I haven't even developed those yet though. Next slots that become available will go on tanks. Okay. I don't have full fuel yet, but we don't have any time anymore. I have to strike. Okay, they can't resist us there, that's good. We have two unassigned aces on fighters. Definitely there is danger ahead. Danger against which we must prepare. Okay. That we cannot escape danger or the fear of it by crawling into bed and pulling the covers over our heads. Germany has said that she was occupying Belgium to save the Belgians from the British. Would she hesitate then to say to any South American country, we are occupying you to protect you from aggression by the United States? Yeah, we don't have any range to actually help with this region here. That's gonna hurt, but we have to do it. Actually, we have an airfield here that we can use. Just realized. The Lutte airfield.
Okay.
Good. Thanks crossed. Canceling the plans. Breaking through. Okay, that will give us that, but there is no, is there a railway connection here? There isn't, there would be that one. So I will have to use this infantry to strike that. Maybe with some tank support from that division. Okay. Now let's check. Supply depot is there and there. Need that railway. There come the trucks. We'll leave that immediate tile unprotected. That is something for the infantry. Hit that. Okay, tanks have broken through. That one tank division only just arrived. You and you stay behind, the others jump across at Mykolaiv. Good. We're gonna secure this area first, and then we strike north to Zhytomyr. Yeah, situation looks all right at the moment. Tanks moving here to cross immediately. Come on. Oh. There we are. Good. Italians are launching their first assaults. Tanks are pushing down south. Those areas are going to be secured in a moment. I'm going to use these fighters that are currently supporting that area. Other two transport wings are gonna supply there. Let me check the main reserves as of now. Fighter reserves basically non-existent. Dive bomber reserves minimal. We're close to getting the first fighter bombers up. Yeah, basically, I have a lot of planes, but not really any reserves. Because the bare minimum of them is actually frontline combat capable. The P-4s maybe somewhat. Ah, fuck that. I'm gonna deploy another beast, another dive bomber squadron. I actually need his fighter squadrons, and that's gonna take a while before I get some reserves of that of them, I fear. I fear we're currently losing more than we're actually producing. That's not good. Who's bombing me here? I have to check that in a second. We're gonna deploy two of these. And I want a medium bomber squadron with a HE-111 P1 deployed too. P4, not P1. There we go, turn that up. We have a significant number of fighters in the west countering enemy air incursions. We're doing a good job at it. Not gonna lie. That requires basically our best trained squadrons to be in the west, which is kind of very annoying. I wish this wasn't the case. Situation here, these guys are steadily advancing, very good. Actually now British troops here it seems. Now that will secure Syria for me, very good. These tanks are about to finish off the encirclement, so that's very good. These guys did actually finish off the encirclement, so that is neat. And they're shipping troops out. That was to be expected, but it's just so I can free up the rear areas. Tanks managed to secure that tile, very good. That is a cute little pocket right there. And these tanks now have supply. We're gonna leave that one tank division to it. It's gonna receive reinforcements from these guys in a moment. And gonna launch into an assault here. To reach Zhytomyr and Kiev, hopefully. Motorized infantry advancing without tank support now. Overrun. Another overrun. Come on, are my tanks faster? They are, another overrun. Cross the river behind Kiev. Terrain here is getting nasty. Okay, the tanks are fanning out now. Kiev has fallen. Very, very, very good. Infantry is taking ages to clean out these positions here, though. And they're basically not capable of cleaning out Odessa under these conditions. Because Japan also upgraded. Japan is slightly upgraded, yes. That's why they were able to advance against... And I think actually buffed them up pretty significantly. So they stand a chance against buffed up China. Let's close. No, close. Oh, that was open. Close those, please. Thank you. Otherwise, Japan wouldn't stand a chance against China, and I didn't want that to happen. Okay, once the new guns are researched, we're gonna start building... And... There, in a day. Okay, that was unnecessary then. There they are. Oh, that's only the first stage. Okay, but yeah. Oh, crap. Mistake on my end. That was supposed to go into tank research. I'm gonna have a few additional slots available in a moment. Why my Grok? Hey, we secured Kiev, so that is neat. Chitomir is not yet in our hands, but we're gonna launch in that direction now. The infantry is starting to bring down these encirclements slowly but surely. But the position around Odessa here is really, really annoying. Guess we have to throw a lot of planes into this region soon. My situation here is all right, so...
Ausrücken.
God, the supply situation is atrocious. Okay, Shitomiya has fallen. Very, very, very good. Redeploying Balk's tanks to Kiev. Combined arms expert, very good. 4 logistics, that is really good. 7 defense on tanks. Interesting. Tank research. Still a bit far ahead. Okay. That means you go in infantry research. We're gonna research semi-automatic rifles now, I think. Good, the infantry is successfully reducing that encirclement now. Yeah, that encirclement is going down. We managed to advance here. These infantry divisions, while exhausted, managed to also achieve something. Push back one of the tank divisions, but that's okay. God, the weather is absolutely horrifying. Okay. Also already muddy again. Tanks launched their attack. Yes, that's a nightmare. It seems we're slowly gaining the upper hand here. Okay, the tanks managed to push these guys out. So we're gonna encircle Odessa completely now. As far as it is possible to encircle Odessa. Oh crap, look at the weather. Yeah, it's still fine. Yeah, the divisions in Odessa are now getting pushed out into that tile, but once the tanks actually reach that position, they're very slow due to fuel issues. But they're almost there. Odessa is basically done for. Yeah, the tanks have now been pushed out. Come on, come on. Yeah, they reached it. That means everybody who tries to get out now gets slaughtered. I probably have to dig in a moment. Okay. Deactivating these, and instead we're activating you, you, and you. But yeah, Odessa is crucial. Cherkasy would be cool to have, but the weather there is, yeah. Let's see if we can outflank and secure it. That would help us massively and probably allow for another encirclement. That's even more. I'm gonna spend ground XP on that. That's the scout plane. I know that our scout plane situation isn't that great anyway. From what I remember. Yeah. Okay, let's keep it that way. And we're gonna take new scout planes as a separate production line that gains some production now. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Odessa Garrison is getting crushed now, finally. That was a nasty fight. The 11th Tank Corps. It's the last unit holding Odessa, and Odessa has fallen. Woo! Okay, that effect was removed. While that is nice, that means the effect from the truck requisitions has worn off. But I'm not yet able to requisition fresh trucks. Damn it. I need more trucks. The situation around here has stabilized from the looks of it. We have an infantry general that qualifies as a field marshal at this point. Heinrici, or Heinrici, I think actually is the term, probably qualifies with logistics 4. Das von Falkenhorst, also not bad. Yeah. That's why I operated in this area, because I wanted to try to advance to Cherkasy, since there is a supply depot. But taking it under these conditions will be very, very difficult. The idea now is to basically use what I gained here. In terms of ground, to help secure total air superiority in this region. There's currently no enemy active in the air. The Shitumiya airfield is fully occupied. Bring the bombers deeper to the south. Some light bombing going on there, but that's not important. God, the supply situation around Kiev is desperately bad. I think once that improves, we should be capable of pushing on that. Okay, good, good. It has improved. Okay, everybody we have. America is not yet in the war, no. Okay, we should be able to take Cherkasy, that should stabilize the line there. Also, upgrading the supply depots here stabilized that position. I just noticed that the supply situation here is okay now, and that the weather here is actually alright at the moment. So what we're gonna do is gonna cross the river with additional tanks, then strike at that tile. It should improve the supply flow from Kiev. Okay, Cherkasy was taken. Very good. Defensive battle and shoes. That's okay. Bulk can deal with it, I think. Yeah, and his tank division is repulsing. And has the armor advantage. The target is Kryvyi Rih, though the issue is that it's not connected by a railway this direction. So, yeah. That supply depot won't help us that much. Kherson would help. We'll advance the tanks here. And maybe we can take Kherson. Since we currently have total air superiority in the region, it's worth a try. What's going on here? Only fighters. Okay, so I don't care too much about that. Throw in everything we have in that regard now, since no air combat is taking place here. 300 fighters into that region. See if I establish air dominance here. And the tanks, despite the mud, managed to attack Kherson and probably secured where the supply depot is. That should be connected. And the weather just cleared up. Weather cleared up and immediately German tanks spring into action. Yeah, that's what we're trying here. Doctrine, floating fortresses, since we're gonna need that in a moment. He is already mud again. Kherson has only rain, so once these arrive and the encirclement is completed, we're gonna strike with the tanks against Kryvyi Rih, I mean. Dead, lost an ace. Come on, tanks, move! Ah, oh, crap, they're out of fuel. These guys have fuel, so we're gonna advance with those. Crap! They just reinforced the Kryvyi Rih. I mean, tanks attacking in urban terrain isn't great, but we're gonna try it nonetheless. God, the weather is killing me. Just as in reality. Hey, Pomidopo, welcome. Crap. Attack against Kryvyi Rih failed. Brought in too many reinforcements, I guess. Let's see if they redeploy. Achtung. I can't even see how many divisions are in that tile. Okay. Leave the Hungarians back, that infantry division, that infantry division, the rest launches against the city. I have no air support in that region, huh? That might be the issue. Okay, medium bombers, support that one. Fighters into that region. Let's bring up the air support. Now, there's not really anything happening here or there. Who's bombing here? Is that mainly the dive bombers, right? Yeah. Don't really have airfields for you. Actually, we do have airfields for you. That means we can pull at least in that squadron 2 and that one here. Okay, with air support, we should have an advantage here that breaks the city. Exhausted and defueled tank divisions are launching into that attack now too. It's risky, but yeah, we have to do something. Oh god, our infantry is getting beaten up by the counterattacks. Oh, give me a second, guys. My wife just called. This is Rasputitsa at the moment, though it might, yeah, actually Rasputitsa, yeah, in some regions still, very bad mud, but here we already have winter in some tiles. In others there isn't that much of it, but it's you can see here down in the south, it's actually pretty neat, the weather at the moment. Please secure that tile finally, for fuck's sake. Okay, these guys now have fuel, so we're gonna deploy them down here and send them into that front. Crap, I'm wasting my tanks here. Hey, creep creep. That tree worry looks like it's falling, so there's that. Let's hope we can hold it. Also, that might allow the tanks, once they have fuel again, to advance if the weather holds. Actually, we have tanks that have fuel, so I'm gonna send those guys in now. And I'm gonna send these guys in. Ah, crap, and there. Just when I thought I might be able to push. But here the weather is alright, so yeah, and immediately the motorized divisions show their well, show their worth. Okay, let's close that. Which just happened? Why did our bauxite suddenly fluctuate like that? Are they still fighting here? Wow, the Brits deployed a lot of troops here. Did not expect that. Okay, that's a surprise. SS tanks. Oh! No, wait. Persia hasn't joined anyone yet. Okay. Okay, these tanks are fueled up. So they are gonna move in now too. And these are gonna follow too. Oh, that's another nice encirclement brewing there. That's a risky one that I'm doing here, but probably it's gonna work out. You hold that position, please. Thank you. Okay, call that off. No unnecessary losses here. That position. Yes! Double encirclement pulled off. Woof! That's what we needed right before the winter. Now it's time to dig in. Didn't we have still divisions at home? No, apparently not. Crap, I thought we still had about 20 divisions at home. Okay, apparently that wasn't the case. Okay, now we're finishing off the encirclements. Against max buff AI, this is absolute pain. Dota 17E2, new medium bomber. Let's check our HE-111s. Oh shit, we're short on trucks. Badly. Where's the HE-111? There. Okay, we're switching 10 over. I tried to push out, but yeah, doesn't matter anymore at this point. Okay, we're gonna dig in now. Bring that down fast. Can we do truck requisitions again? Yeah, if I see an opportunity, I will take it, but... Crap, no truck requisitions. Like, Dnipropetrovsk is a target that I should definitely take, same here. That one is actually exposed and the weather isn't too bad, but they are out of fuel, so I'm just gonna wait for the tanks to get their fuel. Actually, let's check again. I think I'm gonna promote Heinrizi, just because I like him. What are his traits at the moment? He's a genius tactician. I actually want him on the front line, since he's really good. But the leader experience gain is also really, really good. I need another field marshal, there's no way around it. Altenhorst, are you a genius? Awesome tactician. Methodical. By the way, that is something reliable warhorse should probably... I don't know. That both traits are locked behind something is a bit annoying. And he has meticulous planner, so there's that. You can still get positional warfare. Okay, I think I'm gonna make Falkenhorst the field marshal. Yeah, I think he's the best choice. Okay, yeah, Himmler is a field marshal. I know. Yeah, Rommel and Rudolf Schmidt are both currently not serving in frontline roles. I know. Okay, where is he? I'm tempted to make Bulk or Guderian, actually, a field marshal. What do you think about Guderian? But he's a master tactician, but I could replace him with Rommel or with the other one. Rudolf Schmidt. I think I'm gonna make a Guderian field marshal. We'll reduce efficiency of the tanks a bit, but that's okay. And we're gonna put... Rudolf has unconventional, which helps with out of supply, and he's an awesome tactician. Rommel, awesome tactician, also unconventional. Also reckless and frontline general, which is bad. Gets wounded quite often, so we're gonna do that. Okay. Okay, then this is gonna be Guderian's area of operation now. Well, List's area of operation is gonna reduce to this. Hopefully this doesn't cause the total collapse of the German front line now. Due to the armies being completely mixed up. Okay. Ah, the proper Focke Wolf is coming in a moment. Okay, we're gonna use that. And Panzer Division 41 is fully armored, save for the motorized heavy artillery. And obviously the mechanized infantry. Okay, we're gonna deploy additional Panzer IIIs now here. And I'm gonna do something very, very risky. How big is our stockpile of mechanized at the moment? .1k. It might be enough. If not, we have to increase production. But I'm gonna convert all tank divisions to Panzer Division 41s now. Good.
Bereit zum Ausrücken.
Okay, you get a new plan. This is the new plan. And your plan. This with a I'm gonna research them soon. As I will also research nuclear weapons, we might actually need them. We still have manpower reserves, so that is neat. Let's check how many casualties. We suffered 140,000 against the Soviets. And the Soviets suffered 5 million. That might bring us through the winter. Gives us some time to concentrate here. We need to send some air there. That should help us before they advance too far into Iraq. Okay. I'm actually gonna assign Himmler to that theater. Because the Atlantic Wall currently doesn't need one. The Met is more or less safe, yes. I have secured it here, but Gibraltar is not in our hands, and we can't really take it until Spain is in the alliance. We have secured this position pretty well. It has an airfield, a solid one. Currently there are fighters. We have been building a radar there too. And we are building pretty strong fortifications here around Aswan. So, and currently our mountaineers and a few reserve divisions are dug in there. Probably going to convert those over to proper infantry divisions at this point. Naval invasions can be an issue, but I don't expect any. That reminds me, I wanted to train six additional infantry divisions for these guys. Short on trucks, right? Yeah, trucks. Trucks, 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 trucks. It's all trucks. Very good. Time for industry. Where's the currently Fokker Wolf production line? That is currently low priority. It's gonna gain priority soon. Why are you attacking? You had a clear order to not attack, for fuck's sake. Also, screw Iraq. Italians can deal with that. Pull back here. British brought in a lot of troops, but we basically are cutting them off now. More mills. Yeah, we're constructing mills still. But we're also building a lot of railways at the moment to improve supply on the Eastern Front. Now with air support we have a chance to take that mountain. That is Kurdistan, is it? Yeah. So they capitulated just Syria, very nice. Getting logistic bombed. Oh, that's up there again. Probably. Yeah, they tend to do that here, but it's usually not too bad. Situation here is alright. Situation here is alright. There just wouldn't be these casualties. Okay, we have to support the left bank. That should help with that. Ah, crap, we have to ground our Recons. Running out of Recon planes. On the left bank seems more or less stable. Tanks are slowly getting ready again. Gotta pull them back now from the front line so they get supply and fuel. Should also improve supply throughput for other divisions here. Is digging in. Oof! Those SS guys are getting a hammering. Okay, let's create an SS, an infantry division 41. Remove the support and it's actually no wait, keep that support heavy artillery, put the artillery here by removing it from here, that frees up some. They have AA, do they? Yeah, they do have AA. Okay. We increase the number of, and then we give them additional rocket artillery, put AA here, and that slot is freed up then for the assault gun. Yes, that increases their strength to 26. I think that is worth it. Oh, wait a second, no. No, we don't do that. Instead, we put in support anti-tank here. We can remove that one. Yes, that's more like it. And we put the rocket artillery here. So we don't gain anything here. HP goes up, soft attack goes up significantly, and hard attack even does armor now. That gives them 30 armor. Woo! Okay. But we need more trucks. Why can't I requisition more trucks? How long is the cooldown for that? There it is. Give me trucks! 9,000 additional trucks. Desperately need it with 2,300 short. Okay, we're pushing the Brits back here. Thanks to air support. They have an airfield, but they're not using any planes there. Some of my guys are having a field day. Oh, I love successful counter-offensives. These guys now have to wait for equipment, and they are inexperienced, badly inexperienced, so... Once they get the additional divisions, they should be fine. Yugoslavia recognizes the Soviet Union, okay. Not that Yugoslavia currently exists. Good, tiles taken. Great. SS tanks, engaging them here. No, not from Turkey. They, Lebanon split off from Syria. That was in my faction. So Syria had a civil war. And then Syria also lost Kurdistan, then was overrun from both sides, and the British, by having the port of Beirut in Lebanon, brought in forces. But yeah, as you can see, that is not going too well. And somehow the Soviets forced Iran into their faction. I don't know exactly how that happened, but Iran went somehow Soviet, so there might be something wrong there. Oh, okay. Shit's hitting the fan. That is my moment. Let's see if we can pressure Persia now that the Soviets are in that. Okay, they might have military access. That should not be the case. Additional political power ASAP. Yeah, US are at war with us. Fortify naval bases! Immediately ordered. I order shield up. Yeah. Yeah, in both cases, yes. And for some reason, Iran went Soviet. I don't know how that happened. That should not be possible. They went for communism and, yeah, are now in the Soviet faction. Reform the German war economy. Overseas squadron isn't yet combat ready. Crap. They're still short on trucks. We're gonna pull them back. So they can get completely filled up. Kurdistan capitulated. That was the plan. Oh wow, they have a lot of divisions there. That's a lot of Brits going down there. They're actually escaping. Escaping to Turkey. Fuck them. that means I have to then put these guys. Yeah, they're attacking here now, down here. So they can secure the tiles. Yeah, the guys in Finland have not really engaged yet, so. Where's my infantry division 41? There. I mean, at least the Italians are in the war now, properly, and doing something against the Soviet Union by fighting in down here. So that is something. Okay, that ends the threat from here. Okay, I take you guys and put you here. Actually, you know what? Fuck that. We put the full force there. Heavy mortars researched. Very good. Okay. Get me anti-tank grenades too. Need to improve our infantry equipment fast. Ah, crap. I don't know how long the Italians can actually hold this. I'm gonna send the SS tank divisions back down here. Oh god! There they come! Oof! In some areas, they will make progress, most likely.
Ihre Befehle? Befehle? Ausrücken!
That looks all right.
Ihre Befehle? Ausrücken! Ausrücken! Achtung!
Okay, we'll bring you guys to the front line. Ah, crap, that are these. Oh, shit. Okay, these. Sending to Riga. And you too. We need you to stabilize the front line up there north. That one's temporarily assigned to that force. Ah, they're getting hammered here. Retreat across the river. And that's with air superiority in these regions. And solid supply. Oh god! Our transport planes suffered bad casualties. We're out of transport planes, actually. Crap, and I don't have any at home. Bringing in additional bombers. We need to hold Pure and Krivoy Ri.
Angetreten. Zuhören. Ausrücken. Achtung. Ausrücken. Befehle.
They're holding the ground. Shitumi has something we need to hold.
Ihre Befehle? Ausrücken! Ausrücken! Ihre Befehle! Ausrücken!
Ooh, they're pushing back my tanks!
Vorwärts, Männer! Angetreten! Befehle?
Okay, better radars, so that is neat. They arrived here and they are still pushing. Situation in the north? In the north, it's actually looking alright. Much better than I expected it to look. They're not really making any gains here. So, you know what? Fuck that. Bulk. Redeploy here. Redeploy here. Bring you to the front line. No, I don't have Hummel and Marder. Hummel is just becoming available for research now. Panzerkampfwagen 3L is going into production in a moment. We're a bit slow on the tanks since we're researching so many naval techs. Okay, Krivori held. They're retaking that. These guys are holding. Shitomiya is holding. Sending in these guys as reinforcements. Frontline is largely holding. I mean, it's not without issues, but it's holding. Okay, we're switching the Panzer III production over. Back in a second, guys. Okay, so the idea is to pull these guys back. Have them secure Suez and train. Okay, with the infantry and the tanks of the SS arriving, these tiles should be secured enough that I can pull these guys off and prepare to invade, to take Gibraltar to secure this. It will be a slog, but I think we can do it. Since we should enjoy air superiority. Oh! The Italians pushed a bit. So there's that. He already changed the pictures? No, he didn't. Still has air civils and so on. Crap. Baustab Becker! Yes, give me that! We need the Baustab. Time for the Tiger. Ah, that's near mechanized. I think we're currently not short on mechanized equipment, so that is something. We should be able to bring up two fighter bomber squadrons now for training. Yeah, we have enough mechanized at the moment, so that is good. That means we can soon enough. Okay, start converting. Air situation is not great, but also not absolutely terrible, but we need to increase production of fighters. Converted a lot of old fighters over to early fighter bombers. Those should prove useful. Do we have any of the modern? Hey! Panzer 38T stockpiled. See, when we have started stock, yeah, we have them stockpiled the F version. So that means I'm gonna decrease production of these and start putting them putting it elsewhere. Okay. Still producing a ton of them, so that should be enough to replace any losses we suffer in the short term. We have 1,000 of them stockpiled at the moment. I want 20 factories on these. I need more transport planes. Definitely don't have enough. We now have just about enough trucks. We have not been able to introduce the 5 cm pack sufficient in sufficient numbers so far. Need to increase production of that. We're using stockpiles here, largely. We actually need new stuff, would be the AT rifle, AT guns. We have to change that infantry equipment soon. Okay, frontline stabilized from the looks of it. Using the depots closer to the front line now. Definitely helps with supply a lot. Looks like the winter offensive has already died down, or at least taken a short break here. Due to us deploying a lot of tanks to the front lines. Looks like we managed to hold. We didn't manage to hold our bridgehead here, so that is neat. Okay, first operation of our spring offensive would be an attack here through the gap past Minsk and Selihorst, where the terrain is decent. Through the plains there to Bobrushk and Gomel, and the same from Kiev here. From these three positions against that here, through Chernigov to Gomel. So push Gomel. That would encircle these swamps. And we could use that then to stage an attack against Mogilev and Vitebsk, which will threaten the flank here. And maybe at the same time, we can launch an attack from here to Pskov and maybe to Narva, cutting off the troops here and encircle them, pull Finland into the war finally. They are currently not in the one. We have 20 divisions sitting there doing nothing. And finish off the encirclement here between Pskov and Vitebsk. Take Smolensk in the process, probably. And that, then, with this position secured here, we could launch out from Gomel to Shostka and here to Poltava-Kharkov and so on, and maybe complete another encirclement. That's basically the battle plan for 1942. In the process of that, it might be possible then, in the end, to pull down here to Rostov and also take Crimea. And the process destroying as many Soviet troops as possible. Okay, these guys are ready, we can take them. You're gonna ship over here to Tripoli, and from there we're gonna send you guys here, and then to the Spanish border. Romania, do you have more forces? They do. We're becoming part of the D-Day War then. We do the same with the remaining Hungarian forces. Further strengthen the D-Day War. That is not really a war, but we at least started to build up our naval bases. They can't take those that easily. Malaya is gone. It's a nice additional frontline, it's just the mass of Italian divisions is now doing something useful. Yeah, we're gonna train these guys up, so they're not completely useless in combat.
All right.
Okay, decrypted the Brits again. Yeah, I have to end the stream in a moment. Not sure I can actually stream in the evening. Today, we'll see.
Bereit zum Ausrücken.
on the war economy is going through. Will grant me our Albert Speer, which is really, really nice. But we need total war, and that will take a while. Question of push. Nah, I need the war economy first before I go for Spain. I think we held our positions pretty well across, over the winter. Constant air combat is obviously somewhat draining, but it's acceptable. In the air war seems to have died down a bit. Okay. Never before since Jamestown and Plymouth Rock has our American civilization been in such danger as now. The Nazi masters of Germany made it clear that they intend. Let's speed things up a bit since we can't really do anything at the moment. Be fine behind the river there, so we're gonna send them here. Okay, we're bringing these guys into position now. Yeah. As soon as the weather gets better, we'll launch our attack there. Tank situation, light SPA-8 production is rolling. Usually going for total war. Okay, who should go home for that? Probably Bormann. The Japanese are being engaged in China, in Asia, by the Chinese nation. Why can't I get rid of Canaris yet? In the Pacific Ocean. I wonder. Don't know where that decision is to get rid of him. Since he should be able to get rid of him. But for some reason that decision isn't there anymore. With when you get rid of Canaris, it also removes the debuff on your Espionage. So that would be pretty useful, but yeah. I can't at the moment, I don't know quite why. Oh, Finland is coming in! Already now. Okay. Finland has not been called into the war yet.
Befehle!
Yeah, send me scout plans. I'm not calling them in yet. Now I'm calling them in. Okay, Finland is in the war now. That is lodging Soviet troops that were quickly redeployed to the border. Okay, Manila has fallen. Finish him. There goes the Philippines. We're securing the Mannerheim line here. If possible. Field here. But the bombers are not trained up enough yet. Okay, we're pulling Totenkopf and Weaver. Looks like we might be able to take the Mannerheim line here. Here it's a bit dicey, but we're throwing in that division. Crap. Tank division pushed out. They're deploying a lot of troops up north. But it's not enough. Okay, I want a lot of divisions here. So 6 divisions here and 4 divisions here to secure those areas.
Bereit
Okay, we're gonna try and take Murmansk while these guys swing down south. Oh wow, the Finns are actually still pushing. I mean, if it's possible, why not? Thank you. Okay, we are launching everything to start preparing this area for the summer offensive and securing the line for the infantry. Okay, I think I have to end the stream in a moment. We're just gonna secure these positions and then we have to end it. Finnish divisions down there. That should never happen. The Soviet divisions are getting banged up badly. Now on the outskirts of Leningrad. With the Finns.
Bereit zum Ausrücken. Bereit. Ausrücken.
I mean, here it's already basically decided. Once we reach that, they are completely fucked. These guys have no resistance in their way at the moment. Recon Company done. Very good. Okay.
Suchen Deckung.
Good.
Befehle. Ihre Befehle.
Finns are wasting their equipment there. What are our chances of taking Leningrad? Actually not that bad. With the Finns in it, we would actually do it pretty easily, I think. For now we're fine with just digging in there. Soviets are trying some counterattacks in some areas, but that's not amounting to much. It's still becoming something that might be combat worthy. Italians have the gall to push again, which is not going too well from what I can see. Okay, tanks have arrived. Infantry supports that attack on the flank. Okay, we're starting to outnumber them badly, and with that, the battle is slowly turning in our favor. Okay, the Finns are actually still pushing successfully, so there's that. Trying to shorten their front line here.
Ihre Befehle. Ausrücken.
Leningrad looks weakened, so we're gonna strike again. Slight numerical advantage. We might be able to pull this one off if the Finns support us. Doesn't look like they're in the mood to do so. Yeah, when they do it, we stand a chance with their three additional divisions, but they're not really committing. Okay. Concentrating on the fringe theaters at the moment. Okay, river line established and secured, pulling the tanks off for replenishment. Galati. Wow, the Brits are concentrating a lot of troops there now. Finn's doing very, very well overall. Troops are largely just assisting, but it's good enough. Okay, cut off strike. Against the forces on the Kola Peninsula. Horrible terrain, but well, something has to be done. Okay, we push them off here. So that's curtain call for these. And we'll allow one of these divisions to join in the attack on that here. So it seems they have some kind of factory here. I mean, it will be a nice boost for the Finnish potentially.
Ausrücken! Achtung!
Yeah, looks like we're gonna take that tile. Okay, that fringe theater looks very, very good. That is not looking that great, but hey, it's there. It's working. When can I get rid of Canaris? What do I have to do for that? I don't see the option to do so. That's annoying. I really want to get rid of them. Fincy is still advancing, but it's a precarious situation there. Oh, crap. They're throwing in a lot of troops here to try and pull them out or secure that tile. Gonna send that division up north too. Strong are their defenses here? Too strong at the moment, okay. Yes, okay, not necessary to send them there, great. Okay, just hold your ground. Crap, they sent in fresh troops. Now the Finns arrived for support, very good.
Vorwärts, Männer.
Nice experience on that officer, very nice. And Rizzi! Finally got the infantry expert, holy shit he's... Okay, my granddad, not yet granddad. Heinrizi is, yeah, coming along nicely. Approaching his historical capabilities with 8 defense. Heinrizi was the guy who probably stacked up a kill rate of about, I think, it's a bit disputed, but between 8 and 13 to 1 with his forces. So, yeah, he's probably gonna live up to his reputation there. With 8 defense. Crap, look at how many divisions they're concentrating there. I want to attack that across the river. Probably easier to push through that here and then just circle behind them. I wish I had heavy tanks at this point. $600 to attrition. Oh god, we're losing so many trucks. At least we have enough light tank destroyers at this point. That reminds me. So that's the infantry division 41. Sounds like an idea, Division 42. Receives. Motorized rocket artillery here, motorized heavy artillery here. Light SP artillery, light SP artillery. It will drop their piercing slightly, but on top of that, they receive the assault guns. Drops their heart attack. I know. drops it actually quite badly, but I think it's worth it. Hissing doesn't drop too much. The heart attack drops badly, but that's just temporarily until better tank destroyers become available. And I would also like to see that. It's motorized rocket artillery? We don't have enough rocket artillery at the moment, and is that the issue? Tractron rocket artillery, that's what we need. Yeah, but those are quickly to produce, so we can do that. Get rid of that, and get... I'm probably not entirely rid of this. Oh! We have three factories. I'm gonna kick Bormann out. Place him with Albert Speer. That's the first time in a long time that we have three factories. Means the railway projects have finished. Oil situation is good, we're currently gaining oil. Can probably build one more each. Oh, the rest is basically only repair projects, okay. In that case, oh, we can't build that. Can't build that. Wow, they're gonna have to wait until they're back on strength. That's due to the assault guns making up so much of their strength under tank destroyers. Yep, that pocket is going down. Oh, two of my divisions actually got somehow forced back. Okay. Must have been a brutal Soviet attack if that happens. Support that attack. Oh, you can't, okay. Finns are actually pushing here. From the looks of it. Yeah, must have been the Soviets trying to break out here. Immediately go back and secure these tiles. Yeah, the Soviets are throwing everything they have into this tile, from the looks of it. They almost did it, apparently. Pushed two divisions out. Hey guys, you plan up for this. And these divisions are holding their ground. Damn, they're gaining up some experience here, these guys. He has Ranger already. Well, there's a reason I sent him there. Pretty good general. I think he continued to serve in the German armed forces after World War II. From what I remember, Kurt von der Chevalerie. Something is ringing there. look at them. We actually have better Sylveid AA at the moment here in these divisions. Lot of Sylveid equipment. Holy crap, look at that. A lot of Sylveid trucks even. They're waiting for the rocket artillery. That's gonna take a bit until it arrives, but that's okay. Getting a lot of aces at the moment, so that's neat. Whoa, 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 what? Huh? Okay, that's a surprise. I have no reserves for that. Crap. On the other hand, these guys are just sitting around at the moment. Since the coast here isn't secured, yeah, a bit early for D-Day. That's basically Dunkirk, but it's super Dunkirk. And it seems they are not capable of dislodging my forces here, since I constructed the coastal fortifications. Carlos, thank you! Yeah, the coastal fortifications are holding. Very good. Okay, actually not necessary to redeploy these. They might land on an empty tile and then just get slaughtered. But interesting! Yeah, there they are. Why are you leaving your ports? Oh god, I can't wait until you can order them to just not do that, because otherwise you can just make them, yeah. And the Dieppe raid failed. Can we expand those? Fortify the coastline. That's probably dangerous until they actually have coastline protection. Doing this manually. Since a lot of projects are going to be finished soon, then those can go into that. Okay, I think you guys are dug in deep enough now that we can pull these guys off. How's the situation in terms of... they now have level 3 fortifications, so that should be enough. So I'm going to pull these guys off to Tripoli too. They can act as a reserve. Those are basically weaker tank divisions, not quite as up-to-date and so on. I'm posting these guys to here. The fins look a bit exhausted, but that's alright. Ah yeah. Okay guys, that's it for now. I'll see if I can continue the evening. Probably not. I'm already saying that. I might be streaming at weird times over the next few weeks since the little girl is kinda, yeah, sleeping very strangely. So, sorry, Constantine. Did we at least capture a Churchill tank for evaluation? I'm not sure. Probably. Oh, no tank divisions there, so anything captured would go straight into the heavy tank pool. Yeah, we captured 10 Churchill ones. So there's that. We even got that. Okay, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. I'm quickly checking if anyone is online that I could raid. Oh, Shant! I'm just finishing. I'm sorry. I streaming Day9L. Sorry, Shant. I'm gonna send you guys over to Day9L. I'm streaming Victoria. Oh yeah, Victoria there. I'm gonna have some news for you soon. In any case, bye.